Hello, welcome. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use connections with IBM watsonx Orchestrate ADK. Connections are important in watsonx Orchestrate because they enable agents to interact with external applications. Let's begin. Connections have different components. I'm just going to highlight a couple of the most important. One is the wrapper that establishes what application you're going to connect to. The second part is the configuration. In the configuration, you can determine what type of authentication you're going to use and the differences between the draft and the live environment. Then you have the credentials. The credentials contain the specific API tokens or user credentials that will be used by the connection when the agent invokes them. So now let's move to create our first connection. For this example, I'm going to use monday.com. But the exercise is very similar to how this works with any other application. You will have to create a connection, configure the connection, and then provide the set of credentials. Let's go to the example. To create a connection, you have to create a YAML file with this type of syntax. For my example, I'm only going to configure a draft environment. So I will copy this part of the YAML, and I'll modify it in my Visual Studio Code. Okay, so I've created a file called connections.yaml, and I'm going to name my connection monday.com. This is the name, how you will refer to this connection later on. I'm only configuring one environment, my draft environment. I'm specifying that I'm going to use an API key. There's several other types of authentications that you can use. Then you can specify if this is an individual type of connections or if it will be shared by your team. And then you have to provide the URL of the application you're connecting with. Once you have created your connection files, you have to import it. So let's go to the next step, importing connections. To import your connection, we're going to use this syntax. So let's tape it here. And my file is called connections. Okay, it says that it has been successfully imported into our Watson Orchestrate instance. Okay, the next step is going to be to configure our connection. So once you have created a connection, you have to provide additional information to explain Watson Orchestrate, how this will behave, and the different environments that you might have. So we're going to say, I'm just going to copy this. And it has imported our configuration. Now the last step is to provide the credentials. So let's move on to setting connection credentials. We're going to use this different command. So in here, you're going to provide the actual passwords or token or user credentials that your connection will use. Since our example is using an API key, we need to provide the parameter API key and the value of the key. To obtain your Monday API key, you can go to Developers, API Token, and in here you can copy your API key. Great. So we have configured our credentials and provided a set of credentials. Now we can go to Watson Orchestrate just to check if the connections has been successfully registered. So we're going to Watson Orchestrate, and at the pillar menu, you can go to Manage Connections. And now you will see a new entry. In this case, it's called monday.com, which is the name of my app ID. And it says that it's using the API key. You could have accomplished the same goal by going to add new connections and enter all the values manually. Great. Now that we have established a connection, we can start using our connections from any of our tools. So let me go back to the tools section, creating tools, and I'm going to ask the AI to give us the template of a tool that connects to monday.com. Okay, so I'm asking the AI to create a code for a tool that uses as input the title of a Monday request and connects to monday.com and look into a specific border and retrieves all the data of the request that match the provided title. The AI has come up with this answer and has created the code for a tool. We use this as a starting point. Probably we'll have to introduce some changes because sometimes you need to make adjustments, but for the most part, the code seems to be okay. So I'm just gonna copy this and paste it and modify a few things. Okay, so this is the code and I introduced some changes that I'm gonna explain. The first part is I'm making the board ID a constant in my code because I want all the requests to go to a specific board. I don't want this to be dynamic. I updated the name of the tool to be consistent, so I called it Monday underscore list, which is the same name I'm using in the function, to be clear. I updated the app ID to specify that we're using the connection we created before. And here the code is establishing a connection with the API for Monday. Then there is a GraphQL query that retrieves information. I simplify this because it was retrieving additional information that I didn't need it for my example. And the rest is handling exceptions and returning the results when the call is successful. So everything else looks okay. So now that we have created a tool, we need to import the tool and we need to connect it to our connection. So let's go back to our documentation. Associating a connection to a tool. So when you work with a particular tool, you can add a connection to a Python tool using the following. Orchestrate tools, import, pass to file, the app ID, etc. Okay, so we're going to use this command. And we're going to say, okay, now this is running our command. It's telling us that it's not configured in the live environment, which is consistent with what we did. We only provide credentials for the draft environment. And now it says the tool has been updated successfully. Great. So now the tool can be used by any agents. All we need to do, as we explained in previous examples, when you create an agent, you have to specify what are the tools it's going to connect with. So I have created a small agent definition here. This is another YAML to define an agent. This agent is going to help with Monday request, and it's saying that you should always run the Monday tool when the user asks for information about a request. In the tool section, we're establishing that this needs to use the Monday underscore list. That's it. Now we're going to import this agent. Great. So our agent has been created. We can go to Watson Orchestrate and test our agent. So we go to Agent Builder. Now we should see a new agent and it's right here, the Monday agent. So we're gonna open it. And let's see if it's associated to the tool we created. Yes, it's connected to Monday list. So the way this tool has been created is to retrieve items from a board that match a particular name. Before I call this agent, let me show you some of the test values that I put in this board. So I have a project star here. I'm gonna ask for items that have the word star in the request and their name. Are there any items for project star? And we got a response. There are two items for project star and phase one of project star. Let's look at the reasoning. So it identified as the matching criteria project star. It passed this information to monday.com and retrieved this JSON file with the data. Then the LLM read this information and elaborated an English version of the answer. Great. So we have successfully configured an agent that now uses the tool and connects to monday.com to retrieve information. We can continue expanding the functionality and the integration of this agent with monday.com using the same connection. We just need to create additional tools to accomplish different type of tasks. Let's recap. In this video, I show you what connections are in Watson Orchestrate, why they are important, because they allow you to connect to external applications. I show you how to create it using the ADK, configure them, and set the credentials for your different environments. Then we created a tool using AI to establish a connection with monday.com, and we use the connection that we had created in the ADK to establish that connectivity and retrieve data from monday.com. Thanks for watching this video.